my Sagittarian friends, welcome to your February monthly tarot reading, where, as usual, I am here in the beginning of the month of February to give you a look at what the different events are going to be as we transition into February further. Every single week, there's going to be a different set of events that happens in our lives, and we're going to break it down week by week. Let me just get these cards rolled out here and see what we have for you Sagittarians. You had a decent month last month, if I'm not mistaken. So hopefully we've got some good energy coming in for February also. You know, we're coming through the winter months. A lot of us are transitioning soon into the spring. We get closer and closer every day. And so I'm hoping that, again, this will match up with this month's energy, where we are getting closer to that growth concept. There's a lot of astrological growth, by the way, happening in both Western astrology and in like Vedic astrology. Man, is it ever a time for us to take personal responsibility of ourselves. Okay, so if you're new here, I'm Linny, and I have a top row that is dedicated to the four different events that we're going to be looking at for the month. That is four events for each approximate week. The bottom row is going to be the reasons why a certain event above it is happening. And with that being said, if you hear my kids in the background or if you hear Blippi in the background, don't mind. They're just watching TV. And if I have to pause this video to go deal with them, then I will do that. So let's start off with you guys with the 1st of February up until the 7th or so of February. What we've got going on here for you is the Page of Wands. And it's interesting because the reasoning card for you is the Page of Swords. We've got the two pages going on, so we've got a pretty good indication that there's probably some kind of communication that's going to be coming into you. But when the Page of Wands is here in the reversal position, it can have a tendency to being news that feels like it burns a little bit. And with the sword here, right? It's the communicator. It's the sword is that suit of the things that come out in the air, in your mind, out of the mouth, and it cuts direct to the point. And so it could come across as, I don't know if bittersweet is the word that I want to use, but like a bit of information that's a bit of a punch, but necessary at the same token. This could be in the form of course, communication that could come in from family or friends or your boss. It is necessary, but it packs a little bit of a punch. And it can, for some of you, be in relation to something that might have kind of tried to burn itself up in the past with this little burning bush here, and then tries to kind of rise from the ashes some new situation. Like sometimes we get motivated to do things or to, you know, search for a job as an example, because of something burning in the past. Well, this news serves to help us while we are trying to reestablish that new job. Or, we could think of relationships that might have fizzled out a little bit in the past, and somebody comes to communicate about something that might pack a bit of a punch. Whatever this news is, it does seem like in the second quarter of the month, after the 7th or so, up until the 15th, you're going to be likely frustrated about this news, where we are donning the Five of Pentacles here, an obvious description of frustration that can come. But the reason why is because with the Two of Pentacles, you know that what you wanted is not here yet. It's still going to take some time for the ship of your treasures to come in. And for some of us, you know, getting a raise is a treasure. For others of us, having a romantic relationship is a treasure. For some of us, getting that news about the new house that you're going to be moving into is the treasure. And because the ship is not there yet, you're going to have to do a lot of the balancing on your own. Even balancing of yourself is an option while you are waiting in some frustration for the light or the answer or those treasures to start to reveal themselves. Now, for many of you, it could be in terms of relationships that you are rather on your own at this time. You don't have to be absolutely alone, but there is a lot of like singular person energy here. Singular person. And the only depiction of two people coming together is a combativeness energy that we will get into in a moment. So some of you might not be talking to your significant other very well. Perhaps they have the information that packs a bit of a punch. And also this can happen with family situations, of course. Family and friend situations where people just aren't necessarily seeing eye to eye. In the third quarter of the month here, we have, after the 15th or so, a period of healing. That is what the Four of Swords is all about. Regeneration, time to think, some downtime because of, like I said, something that felt a little combative. Some of those, again, are situations that you have dealt with where it has been combativeness between two people. Sometimes this comes across in the format of competition, by the way, which can be work-related. Other times, the kind of competition or the frustration that you're dealing with is inside of your own head, and you're having to balance those thoughts out. See how we've got the symbolism of this? I know it's a five, but there's this, you know, back and forth, almost duality, polarity, rather, energy. Well, there's that polarity kind of energy, that concept of going back and forth, either within yourself or with somebody outside of you, or even a situation. Getting maybe a message that packs a little bit of a punch from your boss where you were told to come in and then you were told, no, we don't actually need you. Whatever it is, it will mean that you are going to have to navigate through these emotions during this month of this head down, time for reflection. And then ultimately at the end of the month here, what you're going to have to do is you're going to have to pick your bootstraps up and get things done yourself somehow. We've got the Nine of Wands as your final energy for the month of February's end, the final quarter after the 21st or so, up until the end of the month. And you'll notice with the Nine of Wands, the reversal is that good support that you wanted. So many of you might feel like, you know, you wanted to have support from somebody or support from your family, but it just wasn't there. And so at the end of the month, you are standing on your own laurels to get things done. Building up, quite literally, building up a situation, building up your lifestyle, building up your jobs, building up yourself. And the reasoning section for why you're on your own is the Devil card in the reversal, thankfully, because the Devil card, when he's upright, is people who are toxically tied together. But when he's in the reversal, it seems you will have freed yourself from a situation that was necessary to free yourself from. And that is the key. And the truth shall set you free, they say. I know I'm ringing a little bit of Jim Carrey energy with that one there, but the reality is that it might feel frustrating and uncomfortable to separate yourself from something or someone, a job, a place, a person. But according to that Devil card in the reversal, this was a necessary step for you. So I want you to take this downtime. If you do end up getting some kind of information coming in as you progress into February about having to separate from someone, take that downtime in the middle of February to really analyze why that thing might not have served for your highest purpose. And then, you know, be that person as you transition into the month of March who not only pulls their bootstraps up, but looks at themselves with a sense of pride that they got it done, you know, that they did it on their own. So guys, I am going to leave you off with that. It seems like a bit of a challenge. It's not the worst month in the world here. We do have you kicking the devil's butt instead of, like, and by the way, kicking temptation's butt is another way of saying that. You have kicked the devil's butt, it seems like, by the end of February, which is good, but I'm sure you can understand that that can be quite an uncomfortable process that I hope will lift itself up for you as you progress into March. Come on, he says. So I'm going to leave you guys off, and I will see you guys when I do your next month's reading. So take care, everybody, and ciao for now. Hello to all of you, my favorite people out there. I'm your tarot reader, Linny D, and I wanted to remind you that every week on Tuesdays is our free Tarot Tuesdays on TikTok, where you can join in and jump into the live streams, ask any tarot question your heart desires, and I will answer it for you right there on the live stream. And as an additional reminder, if you ever want a private reading, feel free to come to my personal website, linnyd.com, where I have all of my readings listed, including some of my most popular readings, like the Ask Any Two Questions for $20 reading.
Click and subscribe to have so much fun with card reading!